each booth has between 3 to 5 minutes. In the first 30 seconds, I advise you to explain, to present yourself, and then there will be time to explain your technology. I'll leave the floor to Muhammad al-Rafi.
How many seconds?
3 to 5 minutes. So in 4 minutes, I'll tell
you to wrap up. Assalamu alaikum, good morning. My name is Ahmed Al-Ghandi, Renewable Project Manager assigned with the GCC Lab by the Tower System. Since the whole initiative was created and developed by the Tower System, the GCC Lab is basically a localization project for power, renewable certification, audit, and appliances safety, efficiency. To achieve the excellence in all these areas, we were able to localize the top tier services through our successful partnership with the leading companies in the power, renewables, and safety. The signing ceremony was sponsored by Mr. Khaled Al-Fali. Following that, and during the first 2 years of operating plan, we were able to achieve outstanding contracts with the major clients in the region, including SEC, Saudi Aramco, Bahrain Water Electricity, Oman Transmission, SABIC, and so many other clients. Solar systems, where the trainer will be able to master all use these tools during the training. It is worth mentioning that we have developed our training facilities to our partners.
We have an example here of one of our young students who is going to give us a brief on our program.
15 seconds.
My name is Abdulaziz Al-Asiri. I'm a student at National Power Electric. I study a core stream. The core stream is divided into 9 months of English, soft skills, and computer and maths. The next 9 months will be job skills, and 6 months will be on-job training. So I feel proud to study at a high innovative and high-tech academy, such as the National Power Academy.
Solar panels and solar products. We develop our plants around the world.
hopefully looking at the agenda. Thank you.
So we have developed a solution for the most challenging problem that we face in the MENA region today. And we have developed a robot complete system that is actually post-processed, multi-managed, and still ready for different types of environments. We have hosting the first robot deployed virtually, and we have reached our healthcare level to make sure that this product actually is on the market. It's an Aramco.
The system is actually cleaning on an angle, making sure that gets removed from the top surface of the panel all the way to the bottom. And is actually maintained by 250 motors, which cuts the budget cost for compared to our competitors in the market. This has been tested on several panel manufacturers, making sure that the brushes doesn't really damage the panel.
So in August department, we are introducing three new tools that we have developed in house. We have the Renewable Switchy presented by Saad Al-Kursari. We have the E-Renewable presented by Adam Chen. And we have the new rooftop DB calculator presented by Bldg and myself, Rahim Al-Yahya. We recently, we have converted the new rooftop calculator on a web-based solution. The user will be able to input their indoor space and three types of input, and they will get the estimated size, cost, two types of charge.
You made my day.
Thank you so much, Abu Khalid. Saad?
Published this or not?
Not yet, but based on your final approach, pilot, and based on your direction, we have made it happen.
The tool, you will find all the layers turned on, and they're just different data that was processed and prepared beforehand to make use by the end user much quicker and easier. So this is all data that was scrubbed from much heavier sources and made into a lighter version so that we could use them on a day-to-day basis. We can use them to make maps, we can use them to share information, and it's basically asset management. So starting with pre-development, if we turn all the layers off, you can see that it's just a basic map, and then you can choose what you want to do with it. You can start with high potential areas and showing where projects could potentially be built, and that's from the earlier phases for the pre-development. And after that, you can go all the way to currently existing assets. So this layer that I turned on just now, the green dot.
So in this regard, we have run a few pilot projects since last 2 years, and I will show a few pictures of the pilot projects that were already done in different locations. So Marjala's Marshall hydrogen and temperature sensors was installed in one of the systems.
Object around the solar panel to the back is not observed.
Our technology, however, absorbs the light from the front and the back. So it's bifacial technology, and it's a heterojunction solar cells. So we have lower temperature and energy temperature losses. So it's more suitable for our clients.
Okay, so today we're going to talk about the AL-Midra replacement project. Just a quick update. The project consists of 10 parts. We've actually completed 2 parts out of 10 parts. We just started part 2 yesterday. It's worth mentioning that part 2 was 10 days ahead of schedule, so our learning curve is actually increasing. Our percentage so far is 26%. And we've actually spent the 34,000 pounds. Now, it's also worth mentioning that our safety is 100% because the human citizens are discharged. And we've also been having tours. We scheduled 4 tours for people to actually go and see the site. Yes, and one of the 5th tour is actually at DC trainees from part of the student mission in the per day, we've actually reached 1,000, I mean 6,000, but the spent yesterday's time spent in part 3, we actually reached 1,900 per day, which is kind of double our daily KPI.
I think you've seen about the iPhone. So the iPhone has started the hosted the digital transformation journey, and it will host an artificial intelligence, a fourth industrial revolution, and internet of things software solution in the power industry, and it will act as a state of the art monitoring and diagnostic center in order to increase reliability by fault prediction, increase efficiency, and then also optimize the operation and maintenance cost. It's worth to mention that the solutions that we will have for people in the iPhone will come on the asset management, smart operation processes, and promote mobility solutions. Now, let's go over the smart solutions with the iPower. It will be implemented into 3 layers. We're starting with the assets by implementing the sensors and then integrated on the power plant level, which is at the 2nd level. And then these data from the 2nd level will be aggregated into the iPower system, which is the
Yes.
هذا الديستريبيوشن الهدف منه انه تو ريدوس تو ريدوس ذا كونسيبت اوف ترانزاكشن اند ديزاين اوف ذا سيرفر ان ذا
ديستريبيوشن. So do you have a, you know, like a picture intelligence type of foreseeing any potential failure?
Exactly. Exactly, we have a study system.
Bye. one is right now it's used as it is. We develop a new algorithm to be used as high speed bus transfer schemes. We have 751 with a touch and the calendar screen. We have a time-based tumbling wave and the time domain differential relays. And we have architecture protections, which is the fastest operations as a critical trip in 2 milliseconds.
That's good.
The overall question is the online monitoring and testing of many transformers, but also 30 users of